to the skies. In the 17th century, many enthusiasts and bold inventors began the race to conquer the skies with gliders and aerostats, and then the first aircraft engine in the 1900s. In 1917, Pierre-Georges Latécoère, a disciplined polymath and entrepreneur, undertook a great industrial venture to build the Samson tube. The construction of this airplane marked a pivotal point for his company, which went on to specialize in aeronautics, and that was a pioneering move, not just in terms of industrial innovation, but also the exploration that followed. At only 35 years old, Pierre-Georges Latécoère was a forerunner who believed we should complement and extend our railways with air travel to enable faster and further travel. In 1918, airmail came into being. Mermoz, Saint-Exupéry, Guillaumet led great explorations. These pilots were considered heroes and wrote the greatest chapters in the history of aviation, carrying freight and mail to West Africa and as far as South America. Latécoère's intuition when it came to airlines was spot on. In 1922, Pierre-Georges was at the helm of the world's first airline, with a network covering 3,000 kilometers, a fleet of 75 planes, and a team of 22 pilots and 120 engineers. In 1923, he was awarded a medal for his contribution to the progress of aviation. In 1927, under the management of its buyer Marcel Bouilloux-Lafont, the airline was renamed Aéropostale. At the time, the airline operated with a network covering 17,000 kilometers. It employed 80 pilots and boasted a fleet of over 200 planes. This fresh momentum came just a few years before all existing airlines merged at the request of the French government in 1933 to form Air France. Latécoère brought a new vision to the industry as early as 1918. Courage, innovation, and passion enabled 50 different types of aircraft to take to the skies up to the 1950s. From the idea of a postal service to making international travel more accessible as early as the 1930s. Latécoère reached its zenith with the Laté 631. This national treasure was much vaunted in Air France brochures. This airliner was one of the very last planes to be made at the Toulouse factory and marked a reconversion of the company's activities. Turning a corner, the DNA of Latécoère was preserved. His adaptability, reactivity, and determination made this possible. The company swiftly and assiduously participated in the Caravelle program, launched in 1951. Latécoère had a brilliant team aboard, enabling the company to evolve towards its new organization. They became the ambassadors of Latécoère's fundamental expertise, which became a manufacturer's partner par excellence. Thanks to them, Latécoère's presence in national and international programs increased, as still is very much present today. We were pioneers then. Our story is one of human exploration guided by a passion for aviation and innovation that has nourished our development across the years. We remain pioneers today. We play a capital role for manufacturers with a unique positioning that combines professional expertise of aerostructures, electrical systems, equipment, and services. We will continue to be pioneers tomorrow. Our R&D is at the heart of our growth strategy, committed to new aeronautical technologies. The Latécoère spirit is the pioneering spirit. Based on three fundamental and historic values established a century ago, they illustrate the durability of the company's quintessence. The valor it took to cross the Southern Atlantic is reflected today in our company's agile minds and great ambitions. The excellence it took to deliver high quality in a short time as in 1918, our commitment to society's greatest challenges. Latécoère remains loyal to its original spirit, which was neatly summarized by its founder in the following statement. I've been over the calculations and they confirm the specialists' opinions. Our design is unachievable. There is only one thing left for us to do. Achieve it. As we enter our second century, our name, Latécoère, is more than ever synonymous with the great successes of aeronautical history. With the same vigor of our founder, for our clients, we go beyond technical boundaries to continue this profoundly human and historic adventure. The women and men of Latécoère are our greatest force, enabling us to react and adapt to the challenges and varying methodologies of our clients. Our irrefutable expertise is recognized the world over, and it is aided by our modern specialized facilities located near our manufacturers. We have reconnected with what is central to our identity, that which led us to achieve the unachievable, from early airmail to modern aeronautics. We will continue to forge the way forward. We are ready. And we are working in concert with our clients to launch the next generation of planes for the 21st century. We made history and will continue to do so. Latécoère, the pioneering spirit.